हरे कृष्णा। दोज हु बो बिफोर द ऑल्टर ऑफ हेट कांट बो बिफोर द गॉड ऑफ लव। सम पीपल बिकॉज ऑफ देयर रिलीजन और देयर रिलीजियस झील बिकम वेरी इनिमिकल टूवर्ड्स अदर्स। देयर डिवोशन टू गॉड मैनिफेस्ट एज हेट्रेड टूवर्ड्स अदर्स एंड दे आर ड्रिवन प्राइमरली बाई हेट्रेड टूवर्ड्स दोज हु दे फील आर रॉन्ग डूअर्स। नाउ इन सच अ सिचुएशन व्हेन दे आर ड्रिवन बाई हेट्रेड वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट एक्चुअली इफ हेट्रेड फिल्स देयर हार्ट देन ऑल्दो दे मे कॉल आउट द नेम ऑफ गॉड बट द गॉड विल हैव नो प्लेस इन देयर हार्ट। What they are attracted, they're driven by, what they're consumed by is hatred. So they are in their internal world, they are bowing down before in an altar where hate is enshrined as supreme. They may not call hate as supreme, but their worldview is defined by the evil other whom they want to oppose and destroy. Such people who do violence in the name of their religion, they're actually not worshipping God. They're talking about God, but in the altar on their heart, in their heart has hatred enthroned in it, not God. The Bhagavad Gita is sometimes mistaken by some people to be a book of violence. However, although the Bhagavad Gita is spoken on a battlefield, and although it concludes in Arjuna taking up weapons to fight a war, the Bhagavad Gita's essential message is not a call for violence. It is a call for transcendence. It is a call for rising from material level of consciousness to spiritual consciousness. And it wants that society also be arranged in a way that spiritual awareness becomes more easily accessible for people. And for that purpose, those people who are anti-spiritual, those people who are anti-social, those people who are vicious, if they are not ready to reform or relent in any way, they need to be punished. So the Bhagavad Gita involves a war that is as a last alternative, and that is not for out of hatred towards anyone. That is primarily for the well-being of everyone, including even those who it is being fought against. Because they, by being spiritually obtrusive, are not only hurting others spiritually, but they are hurting themselves. And when their spiritual obtrusiveness is stopped, then they stop doing bad karma for which they are otherwise going to get large bad consequences. So the Bhagavad Gita talks about war, but it also talks about non-animosity or friendliness. The 11th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita contains a direct call to Arjuna to fight. In 11.33 it says, तस्मात् त्वमुत्तिष्ठ यशो लभस्व इत्वा शत्रुन् भुङ्क्ष्व राज्यं समृद्धं मयैवैते निहतः पूर्वमेव निमित्तमात्रं भव सौम्यसाची। Therefore Arjuna, arise and attain victory. Your enemies are already killed by my arrangement. But then that same Gita, 22 verses later in 11.55 states, मत्कर्मकृन् मत्परमो मत्भक्ता संगवर्जितः निर्वैरः सर्वभूतेषु यः समामेति पांडव। इट इज मत्कर्मकृन् दैट वर्क फॉर मी, मत्परमो मेक मी द लाइफ सुप्रीम डेस्टिनेशन, मत्भक्ता संगवर्जितः दैट मत निर्वैरः सर्वभूतेषु। द रेलेवेंट पार्ट फॉर अस इज दैट बी फ्री फ्रॉम अटैचमेंट and do not be averse to anyone. And if you act like this, yasa mameti pandava, then you will come to me. So the Bhagavad Gita is actually raising Arjuna's consciousness to a spiritual level where even when he has to fight, he is urged to fight without animosity. He is urged to fight as a duty for establishing dharma. So the purpose of establishing dharma and spiritualizing our consciousness is the essence. And when we face opposition, we may have to deal with that opposition effectively, even assertively. But we don't have to become consumed by hatred for that opposition. We focus on our Lord and try to serve Him. When we bow to the God of love, Krishna is the well-wisher of all living beings, Surudam Sarva Bhutanam. He accepts all living beings as His children. सर्वयोनिषु कौन्तेय मूर्तयः सम्भवन्ति तासां ब्रह्ममद्योनिः अहं बीजप्रदः पिता. इन 14.44 ही सेज दैट ऑल लिविंग बींग्स आर माई चिल्ड्रन. सो वेन यू एक्सेप्ट वेन यू आर वर्शिपिंग दैट गॉड देर इज नो रूम फॉर हेट्रेड इन आर हार्ट. And if we devote ourselves to him, then whatever hatred will there is there, that will also go away. Thank you. Hare Krishna.